Well, hi everyone, welcome to the Australian Formula One podcast. As always, you're joined by Pep and Max, and mate, it's been one of the biggest weeks in Formula One. Mate, it's usually you pick up the newspaper in Australia and there's not a lot of Formula One news, but it's actually all over the newspapers. It's exploded. We want to talk about Monza and Spa, but the big news, mate, has been this massive fine that McLaren have received. And obviously docking at the points, you guys have read about the situation. And mate, we've been talking about it quite a lot, and let's just kick off and talk about it, mate. What are your thoughts about it?
Yeah, well, for a start, you are right. It was kind of rare to pick up the Australian press and read about it. Usually Formula One will get about that much of a byline once,
nothing,
you know, once a month. So yeah, it was quite strange to read about it. You know, there's two schools of thought as far as I'm concerned. I think Ferrari will be fairly happy with the fine imposed on McLaren. Jean Todt has come out and said that he's satisfied. Whether or not the Tifosi is satisfied, I don't know. But I think Ferrari's attitude is the fine was warranted. The docking of the championship points were warranted. I'm sure they would have probably also pressed to have the drivers disqualified from this year. But yeah. It didn't happen. And the other school of thought is those that think that the fine was far too much or unnecessary, and that the docking of the World Championship or the Constructors' Championship points this year was enough. What are your thoughts, mate? Where do you sit?
Well, mate, I think the FIA wanted to hit them, you know, both financially and also within the sport. So obviously within the sport means they're not going to win the championship this year as a team, so they've basically handed Ferrari the constructors. And Max, you and I were talking quite a lot about if Ferrari would be treated the same way, but anyway, let us know your thoughts. But yeah, they wanted to hit them in the sport and also hit them financially. You know, Ron Dennis is running a $500 million plus a year team with zero debt, as he said, so you know, the fine is massive. But in the world of Formula One, as we all know, mate, there's a lot of cash. So, but who knows? There's a lot to come, mate. There's talk about Alonso and the still emails, even though some of the emails were, you know, judged to be
false.
You know, what's Alonso's part and the driver's part? And you know, personally, mate, I think the drivers should not be penalised. One of the two is going to win the championship, mate. So. You know, it's a big fine and it's massive news, but I'm not sure if it's too harsh or not. I think the jury's still out and there's still much more to come, mate.
You're right as far as more coming, that's for sure. Some people have, some of you guys have emailed us and you've left comments as well, and you've given us your thoughts on the penalty handed out to McLaren. Some of you are of the school of thought that the fine of $100 million dollars or £100 million, whatever the case may be,
US dollars, mate.
US dollars is too much or unnecessary, and we thank you for your comments. I personally, to nail my ribbon to the wagon, I think the fine is excessive. I think it's unwarranted. I think the damage done to McLaren's reputation alone. And the fact that they've effectively handed the Constructors' Championship to their arch rival is fine enough. As Pep said, you've got a company that makes a $500 million profit per annum.
Well, they turn it over every year.
They turn it over every year. I think finding them $100 million is going to be fairly easily absorbed by a team of McLaren's immense wealth. But maybe Max Mosley has decided the old let this be a lesson to you all type routine by fining them $100 million. I just don't think it was necessary, and I'm quite surprised that it happened. Yeah. But, I mean, it has happened and it's under appeal. Ron's going to appeal, of course. But in saying all of this, as Pep and I were discussing earlier off camera, if I was a Ferrari dyed-in-the-wool supporter or a member of the Tifosi or the Ferrari hierarchy, I'd be extremely pissed off if my major rival had my or had the how to build a 2007 Formula One Ferrari and maintain it, run it and everything.
780
pages. 780
pages
worth. Yeah. Here's this year's Challenger.
And as we said, mate, they would know exactly where to look. They would know exactly what they were looking for.
But the argument is, of course, that as Ron has said unequivocally, we didn't use it. There's nothing on our car that speaks of the Ferrari. Of course, a lot of information could have been obtained, and as far as race setup, brakes, cooling, all of this sort of
everything.
Thing, like distribution,
yeah.
A lot of that, of course, can be obtained by the spies that every team has walking up and down the pit lane. There's a lot of information that can be gathered doing it that way.
And it goes on all the time. I mean,
yeah, absolutely. It's part of the sport. And if your team hasn't employed at least one or two people to walk up and down the pit lane to spy on other teams, then you shouldn't really be in Formula One. That's the nature of the beast.
Yeah.
But I can understand Ferrari people being extremely annoyed that their main opponent had this information. But I'm a personal believer in the integrity of Ron Dennis.
Yeah, mate, the guy's, got
I'm not a fan of Ron Dennis. I don't particularly like the guy. But
in terms of his integrity...
He has an unblemished 41-year record in this sport. And I just refuse to believe that Ron would want to win a world championship by cheating. I don't think he can put his head on the pillow at night. It's not to say he's not a fairly unscrupulous boss, because you've got to be in this business. But as far as cheating is concerned, in that crude a fashion, I don't think Ron would have been up for that.
Well, mate, as things stand, his team's not going to win the world championship. One of his drivers, you know, definitely will, but the team will not. So, mate, we're going to talk about this, I'm sure, again. This is a massive story, as we've said.
As you said, it's not the end of it, mate.
There'll be heaps more to come. So,
stay tuned.
Yeah, as always, let us know what you think. Give us your comments. I got a Model 26, but she stays in her place. I got a